Hi, Gradients. Okay, here's the video that I promised you. Basically, what I'm going to be doing in this video is answering exercise 2 from your textbook. Okay, and I've drawn out all of the questions, written them out, and I'm going to show you exactly how you would approach it if you had the same question or similar question in your test. Right? So, question number one. Oh, wait, before I start there, it is important to note that you know all of your properties of your parallelogram and all your other shapes in order to answer this, okay? So, you're going to refer back to the page that I gave you, that diagram that we drew in class, and we're going to use that to answer. Okay, so question number one says, determine the sizes of the interior angles of the parallelogram ABCD. So they're telling us it's a parallelogram. So if it's a parallelogram, we know opposite sides are parallel. So I'm filling it in. Okay, we also know, let's grab another color. Opposite sides are equal. We also know opposite angles are equal. This one would be equal to the one opposite it. So this is all the things that we know. Now, from the properties that I just colored in or highlighted and filled in, which one of them can help us figure out what the value of x is? That's what we're basically asking ourselves. Now, remember, I keep doing this in class where I say the geometry is over, now we're doing algebra, right? That there means I usually set up an equation and then we use that equation to solve for unknown variables, which is exactly what we're going to be doing now. We look at this. And if I say that the sides are equal and this side are equal, it's not going to help me determine the values of the interior angles, okay? If I say opposite angles are equal, that is true, this plus this, this and this are equal, and this are equal. So what you can do, an option, is write this here as 2x minus 30, okay? And this idea is 2x plus 10 degrees. And then add this plus this plus this plus this to give us 360. That is totally an option and you can do that, okay? Instead, the option that I'm going to use, let me create a different color, is, is that this line here happens to be parallel to this line here. We noted it. So I can see a U, okay? From my fancy stuff, okay, that we were taught in grade 8 and 9. And because I see the U, I'm going to actually turn the page around. Here's the U. Because I can see the U, I know that this angle plus this angle should give me 180 degrees. And the reason for this is co-interior angles. So how do I set up everything that I just said? I'm going to start by saying 2x minus 30 degrees plus 2x plus 10 degrees equals 180 degrees. And my reason for this is co-interior angles. Which lines are parallel? Which two lines did I use that were parallel? It's AB parallel to DC. Okay, how did I know that they were parallel? Sorry, it went out of focus. There we go. And there we go. I've put down my statement. I've put down a reason. Okay. Now this is where I say the geometry is over. We're done with the geometry. What we need to do now is use our algebra skills and solve for the unknown. So I'm going to add the like terms. Right, I'm taking this negative 30 over and my positive 10 over. Give me 180 degrees. It gives me 180. You can use your calculator. 180 plus 30 is 210. 210 minus 10 is 200. Divide by the coefficient of x. So we figured out that x is 50 degrees. But then we go back to our question. Our question says determine the sides. The sizes. Again, I made the silly mistake. I did this with one of the classes also. The sizes of the interior angles of the parallelogram. So that means they don't want just x. They want to know how much this whole angle is. How are we going to do that? To work out angle A, right, I'm going to put this there so you can see angle A is 2 times x minus 30 degrees. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. 2 times x minus 30 degrees. This gives me 70 degrees. You can plug it in on your calculator, right? I know that angle D is going to be 2 times x. Oh, x is 50. Plus 10 degrees, which gives me 110 degrees, right? And then we know D is equal to B, A is equal to C. So I'm going to write that down. Angle C is equal to 70 degrees. Angle B is equal to 110 degrees. And remember, everything that I put down in geometry, I need to put down a reason for it. And the reason for both of these is that opposite angles of palm, and we can abbreviate parallelogram as palm, equal. That's my reason. And there we go. I'm done. Okay. I hope that you actually worked through this question, right? So if you haven't, if you just watched this video by just watching it, please, I want you to pause this video, go grab a pen and paper, open your textbook, look at the question, draw it out, and as I'm working through it, I want you to be working through it as well. That's how you're going to learn, and that's how you're going to master this concept and be able to do it yourself in the test. Okay, let's go to question number 2. It says, PQRS is a palm with angle P equal to 60 degrees. Okay, that's been filled in for us. And PQ equals PS, so that's denoted by this lines here. If you want, we can put it in color. I like using color in geometry, so that's what I'm going to do. That side's equal to that side, right? Question says, calculate the sizes of angle R, this one here, angle S1, angle Q1, Q2, and S2. Okay. Now generally when we do this in geometry, now you can figure it out in whichever way you want. But in most cases when they give it to you like this, they want you to sort of figure it out in that order. Okay, that's why they gave it in that order. You don't have to, it's a mere suggestion for you. Okay, before I start with my question, I'm going to highlight or fill in the information that I do know. Right? If it's a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So if this one here is denoted by the two lines, this idea must also be denoted by the two lines. If this idea is also two lines, this idea is also two lines, right? That there denotes that opposite sides are equal. Right, let's fill in other information. Opposite angles are equal. This one is equal to this one. This one is equal to this one, right? Let's fill in more information. This side is parallel to this side, and this side is parallel to this side. Okay, now that we have all of our information filled in, let's actually go through the answering of questions. It says calculate the size of angle R. We already seen that they equal, so let's write that down. Done. Once I figured it out, I like to fill it in so that I can use it in further questions. Then it says angle S1. Okay, here's angle S1. Now this one requires a little bit more thinking. Angle S1 is actually equal to angle Q1. How do I know this? Because see, if this side here and this side here are equal, it forms a triangle for me. Let's redraw this triangle. This side and this side are equal. This is the angle in question. See, there's this rule that says angles opposite equal sides, because this here basically forms an isosceles triangle. So this angle here is also equal. Right. So I'm going to say angle S1 equals to angle Q1. Reason, angles opposite equal sides. Right. Now, to make my life a little bit easier, what I'm going to do is I'm going to name angle S1 any alphabet that I want to, okay? I'm going to pick it as Y. Doesn't matter what alphabet you use. That means if this one here is Y, this one here also has to be Y, isn't it? Alright. Now, I'm still working in this triangle. Let's fill in the Y here and the Y here. So, you know, this here is 60 degrees. Basically, we're working in this triangle. There it is. If I had to add all of these angles up in this triangle, it should give me 180 degrees. And the reason for that is the sum of interior angles of a triangle. So let's write that down. Angle in triangle PQS, PQS, angle B plus angle Q plus angle S must equal 180 degrees. Okay, angle P we know it to be 60 degrees, so I'm going to fold that in there. Angle Q1 we said we're naming it Y, so let's put that there. Angle S1 we also said was Y. 180 degrees. Geometry done. Now time for our algebra. Y plus Y, do I? -160 = 120. Divide both sides by the coefficient. Therefore, angle S1 equals 60 degrees and angle Q1. There we go. Right, they wanted us to figure out S1, below again, S1 and Q1. We did that, S1 and Q1. Once we get the information, fill it in. There we go. Okay. Now we need to figure out angle Q2. Okay, let's use a color pen to show you what's happening here. Angle Q2. You follow with my highlighter as we go in. That there forms a Z or N, right? Meaning that this angle here has to be equal to this angle over here. And the reason why I can do that is because this side here was parallel to this side here. I already filled it in. So we can say angle Q2 equals to 60 degrees. Alternate angles. And then you have to state which lines are parallel. We used PS parallel to QR. How do we know that they parallel? There we go. Right. Let's fold this in. Okay. Lastly, so we figured this one out, we need to figure out angle S2. Let's look in this triangle here. QSR. This angle happens to be equal to this angle. How do we know that? Because SR is equal to QR. So it's going to be a similar situation to this, just in this triangle this time. Right? This is equal to this, so this is equal to this. So let's write this down. Angle QR is equal to angle PS, and angle SR is equal to angle PQ, we first have to write down how we know that this line and this line are equal. Okay, opposite therefore angle I'm just writing down how I know that angle QR equals angle SR. This one equals this one. Okay, I'm out of space here, so I'm just going to continue over here. And we're done. There we go. Okay, I'm going to pause this video and then get the next few questions. Okay, next question, question 3. It says KLMN is a parallelogram. Also, I just want to make mention, see how we name it? KLMN. It goes in order, right? Calculate the sides of the interior angles. Okay, let's first fill in what we know. For a parallelogram, we know opposite angles are equal. That looks interesting already. I don't even have to continue, but I am going to continue, right? Opposite angles are equal. We know opposite sides are equal also. This equals this. This one equals this one, right? We know that opposite sides are parallel. So from all three of these properties that I've just listed down, the one that we're going to be using is that opposite angles are equal, right? Because that's the information that we have. We have nothing about the sides yet. And we don't need the parallel lines. Because if we're going to use the parallel lines, we're going to use a C or a U from co-interior angles. And we don't have information about this. Okay, so let's write this down. 5x minus 12 degrees. You can write down first angle K equals angle M. It's not necessary. Purely just to show you what we're doing. You can do it in your test if you want to. Opposite equals 3x plus 18 degrees. There we go. Statement, reason. We're done with the geometry. We're solving for the unknown using our algebra knowledge. Let me just grab my calculator. In case we need that. Okay, so 5x minus 3x equals use your calculator, divide by 2. Okay, but this isn't what they wanted from us. They wanted the sizes of the interior angles. This is very similar to question 1. We're going to figure out angle K by saying 5 times x. X we know is 15 degrees. Minus 12 degrees. We're going to work this out. We're going to work out angle L. Let's first work this out, right? Gives us 63 degrees. We know that angle M is basically the same thing. Now we need to figure out angle L. And if we figure out angle L, we'll get angle N. Now we're going to use our property of co-interior angles. Because if I do this, there's a U, right? I can do co-interior angles. So I'm going to say angle L co-interior angles. How do I know that they're co-interior angles? Because KL parallel to NM. How do I know that they parallel? Figure this out. L plus 63 equals 180. L equals 180 minus 63. And oops, sorry about that. And lastly, angle N equals 117 degrees opposite. There we go. And we figured it all out. Okay, let's do question number 4. Okay, we're getting a bit more intense and a little more difficult each time. So it says in triangle, so now we're working with a triangle. So automatically in our brains, when we think triangle, we should be thinking sum of interior angles of a triangle add up to 180 degrees. Okay, so it says in triangle ABC, angle A equals 80 degrees, okay, fold in. Angle C equals 35 degrees, fold in. It says calculate the interior angles of parallelogram MENB. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fill in or highlight for myself MENB so I know where I'm working, right? Now they just want us to give the interior angles of MENB. That means this one, this one, this one, this one. Right, let's look at our diagram. The first thing that we can figure out is angle B, right? How do I figure out angle B? I'm going to say in, let me write a little higher, in triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals 180 degrees. Right. Angle A, we've got it to be 80 degrees. Angle B, unknown to us, so I'm just going to write B. Angle C, angle C is 35 degrees. Equals 180 degrees. Right. Therefore, angle B is basically 180 minus 80 minus 35. What's that? 65, I think. Let's work it out. 180 minus 80 minus 35. Yep, 65. That's what angle B is. Okay, I'm going to take this. I'm going to fill it in over here. If we look very closely at our parallelogram, we know that the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So if this here is 65, the side also has to be 65. So let's fold that in. Opposite angles of a parallelogram. Right, let's fold that in. Right, if it's a parallelogram, we know that opposite sides are parallel. And if they are parallel, then I can, let's put it in like that. I can figure out a U like this to get angle N1. Right, so angle N1 plus angle E2. Let me show you this. Equals 180 degrees. Let's go back. N1 plus E2, right? To make the U. Reason, co-interior angles of, just co-interior angles, and then we need to state the sides that are parallel, M, E, B, N. ME parallel to BN. How do we know that those two sides are parallel? We're going to say opposite sides of palm parallel. Okay, N1 we don't know, so we're gonna label it as N1 still. E2 we figured it out, it was 65 degrees equals 180 degrees, so angle N1 equals 180 minus 65, 115. Oops, 115 degrees. And if we know what angle N1 is, this angle, we know now what angle M2 is, because opposite angles of a palm are equal. Ooh, angle M2 equals 115 degrees, opposite angles of palm equal. Okay, I'm going to stop this video over here and then I'll write out a few more questions and we'll do a part 2 where I do more questions. All right.